this is the set of things that we will be covering today in the workshop. We will be accessing the cluster that has been set up for you, and we will be getting started on seeing how OpenShift works on IBM Cloud. We'll have an overview of it. We'll see how it is. You can access and set up your CLI tool so that you can connect to the console through connect to the OpenShift clusters through your desk from your desktop itself, or also see them on the console as to how it works. So if you come down a little bit on step one is where you have to go to this link in order to claim your cluster. Please enter the lab key as OS lab and your IBM ID. I'm hoping all of you will already have your IBM accounts, IBM IDs created on cloud.ibm.com. So please enter that IBM ID. Click your the submit button. And on that, you'll be able to see your cluster. So once you have done that, if you come to cloud.ibm.com, you have to go here and select the account that has been provided for you from here. Once you have done that, click on the hamburger menu and go to the resource list. Then you'll be able to see your cluster, whatever the name it is probably as listed OS201WS01. I'll just wait a second before everyone claims their clusters. Getting back, so now I am hoping that you have claimed your clusters and you are have been able to go there. So click on the cluster, name of the cluster that is provided to you, and you'll be able to see a page that will take you to the setup for your CLI tools and all of that.
Sorry to interrupt. I guess the trying to access the admin page and not the thing. So can you paste the link where they need of the cluster they need to get access to again?
Give me a second. Okay. Yep. I'll just give it 1 second.
Actually, the GitHub on the GitHub link, no, readme, it is pointing to the admin page. So that's why everyone's
that's what I'm used.
Yeah. If you just can change it there. Yeah.
I'll change it there. Surprisingly, Mamta, along with your internet connection, my one also went down and I had to connect with my hotspot. So things are going to be a little slow, is what I can understand right now. Yep, I'll just change this. I will also, paste it on WebEx. Here it is. So if you now go and do what I was saying sometime before, I'm sorry for the goof up. If you open this, you will come to the Cloud Lab page and you can enter your details there and you can claim your cluster. Okay, so like I was saying, if you go to the OpenShift overview, is where you will be able to see your OpenShift clusters. What you can do is you can click to create a cluster from there. If you would not have already had a cluster provision for you, but it is already done. So what you will now do is install the CLI tools that you need in order to connect your cluster from the desktop. So go to these links and download the kubectl one and download the one for the OpenShift cluster. Yep, Mamta, you're saying that they can use the Cloud Shell. Yep, you can also connect using the Cloud Shell. And that will, I think, be a little easier and faster to connect. However, if you prefer to do it this way, since I'm using a Mac, I have downloaded the ones for Mac. The cluster that you're using is a 4.3. So when you open the open to download the OC client, come down to the list and download the one for 4.3.19. This will now be the kubectl one, and I will save both of these. So once you have done that, please remember that you'll have to move the OC and kubectl, both of these files, to user bin local bin OC slash OC for the people who are using take you highlight you through what I have done, and I'll wait another minute for you guys to finish up this step before moving on to the next one. Assuming you have covered this step and you have been able to set up the CLI tools that are needed. My connection is a little slow, so I might go off and on. Please bear with me. So if you have been able to do this, you can also, if you have already done this login before, you can also, try to do it, try to see how you can connect to it later on. And you can remember to always connect with the CLI from this page if you are coming back to it for the second time. to check if you have had the connection, run the command OC version and you will be able to see this. If you are being able to see this, it means that your connection with the cluster is right now on. Open the OpenShift console from the previous page and click on Create Project. Enter any random name, my project, a new project, whatsoever, and enter a display name that you want to be displayed. So the things that you can see on my left are the projects that I'm already having on my cluster. You can provide a description and click on Create. So this is a very easy way to, you know, create a new project on the cluster on the through the console, and you can now provision your app on the cluster through CLI or through the console. So now that we have done this through the console, we will just take a look at the project that we have created on the console, but through the CLI. So remember that you'll have to have your login working. You have to log in through CLI and then only you can move on to the next step. I just checked if I am already logged in. Yes, I am logged in. And if I am now doing OC projects, these are the projects I will have. And you can see on the sixth or the seventh line, new project one, dash project one is the one that I just created right now. So we will be providing all of this and I will be uploading all the videos and everything up on the GitHub folder or on the Slack. Even if we are missing on a step one or two right now, and if you are not being able to run through, please let us know on Slack. So to create a new project on through the CLI, all you have to do is OC new project and name of the project, the description and the display name. You can see the commands. These are already given on the GitHub repository that I have shared with you. Debjani, could you please increase the font of it? We have people asking for the font size to be bigger.
I don't think I'll be able to increase the font size, Mamta, sorry.
Just do a command plus on the window.
No, this will not be increasing because I am sharing a pre-recorded version since my internet is not that stable right now.
All right, okay.
So I'll be sharing the whole recording with you guys. Alternatively, all the they are also provided videos that I am running right now are also provided as GIFs on the repository. So if you can take a look there, both of these are same. So we have created a new project through CLI. What I'll do is go to the console and just view the created project that I'm having. So yeah, that is my home. And my projects, and I just created a project named Hello OpenShift. You're seeing that on the console.
So let us try to delete the images that we are creating.
Devjani, can you run that recording once more?
The previous one?
For the creation. There is a request for that.
So we ran that, we went through that there are two ways to create a project. So if you create through the console, you can directly go and click on create a project and name the project, and that is done. However, if you're doing it from the command line, what you have to do is copy the command that is provided on the GitHub repository and paste that. You can name it accordingly, however you want it, and that should do. So it is OC new project, name of your project, space, backslash, dash dash, description, and within quotes, your description, whatever you're providing, again a space, two dashes, display dash name, and within double quotes, the display name of your project. Going back to deleting a project through the console. Project that we had just created. Project with the name of the project that just deletes the project. That's it. Very straightforward and right there. As you can see, project hello dash OpenShift has been deleted. And I'm rechecking this, confirming this on the console. It is not available there also. So in order to delete the project from the console, all you have to do is similarly go to the project and delete it from here. So that was very easy, four steps just to get started and just to get our hands dirty, breaking the ice as to how to manage your projects from the CLI and on the console. Moving on, I will be next showing how you can deploy an image from an external registry. Again, if you look at the GitHub repository, you will have a example Python app. So that Python app you can download and you can dockerize it. I hope you guys are logged into your Docker hubs. So if you want to use the same image that I have used, you can just follow along with the process. But if you want to build the image on your own and then you want to deploy the image that you are building yourself and pushing on your Docker registry, it will take a minute or two more. However, you can still follow this. So I've already, like I said, dockerized the image, and here I'm providing the name of the image. It is a public image. So once you have done this, just go down below and you'll find an option to click create. Click on create and you will come to this screen. The topology is where you will be able to view your builds. If you click on it, your routes will be exposed right here. And that's the app that has been deployed. You can see Hello World. So I guess we can understand that if you have an image, an application that you are building from scratch and you're being able to, you know, Dockerize that and push it, deploying it on OpenShift is like a piece of cake. It's quite easy with the applications that are, you know, small, that are easy to build. And to get started, this is the easiest way that you can. So this is the running app that you are viewing right now that we have just deployed. Up next, what we will do is deploying it from deploying an app from GitHub. Once again, all the steps are mentioned also on the GitHub repository. If you need to clone an app that I have used, you can use that. So what I am doing right now is deploying the same app through GitHub. And if I go and view it again on the console, I'll be able to see the image. So I think I have skipped a step there. So I'll go back and show the commands that I have run. So all you have to do is OC new app and you give the GitHub application that you were running in the previous step, OC new dash hyphen, OC new hyphen app and the repository. And a Docker image that was previously built will be up. The next step, if you go and run the command OC expose SVC, that is services slash deploy the name of the app, Python OpenShift tutorial. The routes are exposed. And I will once again be able to go to my topology and view the running app. You'll be able to see the app that was running on the GitHub repository that I have given. You can see that the deployment has been successful, and you can click on the topology to view the routes, and click on routes to see your Hello World app again. So as developers, before going to the next step, I'll just talk about a few things. What we usually do day in and out is to write applications. So you know that when we study about OpenShift, there are certifications that Red Hat offers, and there are a lot of courses that you can do on Red Hat's website and on IBM Cloud Docs. And then there is a portal known as developer.ibm.com, which I will be also covering at the end of the slide. So what we do is we come to know that the OpenShift learning track has two tracks. One is the admin track, the things that I am doing currently as to, you know, how you can deploy your application on a cluster. There are different ways to deploy applications on a cluster, and you also need to, you know, write applications as developers, and you need to test them out and create the changes. And so you run your builds, right? You have some issues that you want to fix, or you want to add some functionalities. What you do is you just Jenny, can you hear me?
Yes. Did you lose me?
Yes, we lost you for just maybe 30 seconds. You can just repeat that statement.
Sure. Yeah. So like I was saying, that as developers, we tend to write application and we tend to create changes, maybe as feature requests, or maybe as, you know, fixing a bug and we want to push it. So for doing that, for your everyday task that you're having, it is not always possible to, or not always even advised to, build an application every day, and, you know, again delete the project and build another, because you will have a limit of the number of projects that you can build. So what do you do in those scenarios? Today I'll be showing you a very quick and easy method as to how you can trigger your own builds. So we have seen that there are two ways to create projects or applications that I have shown, through CLI, through the console, and you can use this to your advantage. And there are also templates that you can use for all different kinds of source codes and applications. These are the standard templates. So for pushing changes to a repo, probably for GitHub, all you need to do is to run the steps that I'm going to be running next, because behind the scenes, OpenShift is going to take care of the rest of the things. You go to your projects and you add a project from catalog. I was running a Python one in the beginning, and I will continue with another example Python that you can also find over here. So what I have done is, at this moment, there is a sample repository that is provided. So what I have done is I have cloned this sample repository, so that if I am doing a change right now and trying to show it to you, it will immediately, you know, trigger a build. And that will work for you. So I will suggest you to go to this sample repository. When you are trying to add this, you'll be able to copy the link. It is also provided on the GitHub repository. So copy the link and clone it, or fork it, and paste it. Paste your Git repository URL on the place provided right below where my cursor is.
This also has a lot of other information, since this is one of the official bills that are present here. So this is the one that I have, forked into my account. I will be copying the link and pasting it here. And the next step would be to, go to advanced options. You can provide a Git reference and all of that if it's necessary. So when you go to secret, you'll have to create a secret with your own credentials. Just name the secret anything you want and remember the name. Might want to change any of these, or you might want to keep all of that options as you want. I'll just show you. I had created that before. I'll just show you. When you go to create the secret, you'll have to give it a name, and you'll have to keep the basic authentication just like that. Provide the GitHub username and provide your GitHub password. Done, click on create, and once again you'll be able to see that your build is running. While we give that some time, go back to your GitHub account on the same repository, click on settings and go to webhooks. On webhooks, you'll have to enter a URL which you'll be able to find on your console. Click on builds and scroll right down. You'll find the GitHub webhook given there. Copy the link. Go and paste it on the payload URL. Also, remember to change the application type as JSON. I had forgotten to do that and I had to run this once again. So enter the name of the secret that you had given back. I will run this once again. So I am seeing some text as to this is a little confusing. I'll be running it once again. I'm running this step again. We have already had created a project that we had. We will click create or click on add and search a Python application or any application for that matter. So you can go to the sample repository that has been provided and you can fork it, so that you can do the changes on the next step. So I have done my part of forking here from the main project. And I'm pasting my own repository here. Click on advanced Git options. And you'll be able to see an option with source secret. Click here and create a new secret if you don't have already. Since I have already had one, I selected one that I already had. Yep, there is a Slack link. Raghavendra or Mamta, if you could please paste the Slack link. Thank you so much. So if you did not already have created a secret, you can create one again. So create the secret name, keep the basic authentication just like that. and provide the GitHub username and password that you have yours. And once you have done that, click create. Click on this and you will be able to see your first build that is running. Go back to your GitHub and click on settings and webhook. On webhooks, click to add a webhook. Go back to your build. And on the build, scroll right down and you'll be able to find the copy URL for GitHub. Copy the webhook URL and paste it on GitHub. Select the content type. Please remember to select the content type as JSON and enter the name of the secret that you had created and click on add webhook. Better to click on send me everything so that when you, if right now when we are, you know, running a very small change on the UI, that also gets updated for us. So while my build is finishing up, we were here when we finished up the build. I'll quickly go and see the index file, the HTML file, where I can do a small change on the UI. So remember to, you know, once you have done the previous build, click on the topology to view the page that was opening for you. So you will be able to see what you were viewing. So on that page that opens up once your deployment is done, I will just put down trigger test successful so that once I have triggered a second build after this, I'll be able to see it happening. If you go to your webhooks now, also before that, if you go to topology, you will be seeing that your first build is was completed sometime back and the second build is running now. Why it is running? Because you have done some changes in your code and you have pushed it to GitHub and it is running a build automatically. So now when you open the link, you'll be able to see the page trigger test successful. If you come down on the webhooks page, you'll be able to see the recent deliveries, whatever was done from your GitHub. So this is the page you'll be able to see whatever you have written, whatever changes you have done will be coming up on the trigger test successful space if you are doing it here or if you're just deleting the whole thing. Also, this page contains a lot of information as to about the resources, about the about managing your applications and all of that. You can go through them. I have also provided a set of resources on the GitHub repository that I have given. I will provide a recorded video of the whole thing up on the same Slack channel that we are having. So in the whole thing we saw in the previous step is known as source to image deployment. So when the application was created in the backend, a job was run that powered the deployment of the application. you as a developer, you're working on the code on GitHub, which has created a trigger through the webhook. And that created a Docker image of the source code. It has put it into a private registry built onto OpenShift and pushed to the actual cluster. Whenever a change is detected in an image, the image stream will push that without having any downtime of your app. And the new version will be replacing the old version. So I'm hoping we all have been able to follow through the workshop. The GIFs are already provided on the GitHub repository that I have given. You can test it and you can run it. Your clusters will be available for 48 hours as much as I am aware of. So you can try and test all of these, and you can try and test a lot more things that are available on. You can see the documentation best on OpenShift's official documentation page. And all of these things that I have covered is mentioned very clearly. All of the things that Mamta has covered today are also covered very nicely on those pages. Okay. So I'll just stop sharing my screen now. And we'll take up any questions that we are having.
Before we take up questions, I thought I'll just talk about all of the
We'll just cover a little bit about call for code. Over to you, Shiva. Sorry, and then we'll move on to the Q&A. Thank you so much.
I just wanna share the screen.
Get to see. Not yet. Starting to share content.
I think we have covered the
Yep, I think we should be good.
Awesome.
You might want to stop your sharing and start it once again.
So people, I don't know, somehow my, wow, even my sharing is not working right now. Okay, let's move ahead, otherwise we are just wasting time. It's not sharing right.
You want to take them through the call for code page? I can show it and while you speak.
Yeah, but I'm not able to share. Yeah
sure.
You want me to show you the call for code website?